You're watching Bruniverse Videos. For more videos, check out jimbrewer.com.
Comedian Dave Attell. You guys all know Dave?
Just know maybe.
Big blank. Sorry, Dave.
David Do Tell. A one-liner from him. We might know him.
David Tell once said on stage, a true friend is someone that you can call in the middle of the night to help change a tire. But then he went on to say, a real true friend is someone you can call in the middle of the night to help bury a body. If that scenario went down, Lars, who'd you have to call? You're in a serious situation. We're not even going to ask questions. But out of these guys right here, James, Kirk, Rob, you can only one of these guys you're going to call. Who's going to help you?
The issue is not who's going to help me. The issue is who's going to answer the phone at 3 in the morning. And that's where it gets a little complicated. Let me see. Between the three of them, the one that has the highest batting average on answering the phone, man, we're down here in probably in double or single digits. We're not even triple digits. Highest batting average of answering the phone between the three of you.
Is text included in that?
Text is definitely included.
All right.
We'll even throw in an email.
Okay, text. If you include texting, then I'm gonna have to actually say that I would go to James first, because he that doesn't mean that James is in any way an efficient answerer, but he'll usually get back to me texting before these two guys do. Usually, I would say between the three of them, Rob probably answers his phone slightly more than the other two.
Fair enough. Kirk, how about you?
Well,
first of all, when you finish crying about what happened,
crying about the body.
Yeah. Well, you know, my answer is based on probably who I would call and then say, but don't tell the other two guys. you know, that's a hard one, because I would expect that all three of these guys would be able to help me in a time of dire need or embarrassment or whatever, but I have to say, the man of action would probably be Rob.
I predicted that.
Yeah,
he would
show up at my doorstep, no questions asked.
Bang.
That's important. Whereas
James is gonna show up.
James would be
what happened?
He'd show up and he'd be pissed, and then Lars, if he'd show up and he'd have a million questions for me. But funny. Yeah, I think I could rely on all of them.
I think that would be part of the initiation for me, you know, being the new guy. Hey, Rob, you got to help me bury this body, man. Don't ask questions, okay?
Bring the shovel.
Bring the shovel. Yeah. Don't ask any questions. You bring a shovel. Keep your mouth quiet.
What about you, Rob? You're a new guy.
Oh man, that's a tough one. Again, who would answer their phone? And Lars would probably be the first at 3 in the morning to answer their phone. These guys are in bed a bit earlier than any of us, so I'd have to say Lars.
Well, I'm hearing a bunch of questions within the question, all right? Who would pick up their phone?
Mm.
Who's the most reliable?
Mm.
And who would you go to first with something deep and dark and ugly?
Mm-hmm.
All right? Mm-hmm. I think any three of these guys would do one or two or even three of those. But the first person I would call would be Lars.
Bang.
Yeah.
Zozo.